To help understand fugacity, we'll look at three questions that compare fugacities of different components or the same component at different concentrations. So first, go ahead and read through these questions and on your own, answer them. And then one by one, we'll go through the explanation for each of the answers. So for this vapor-liquid mixture of a binary component, we want to know which component has the higher fugacity in the liquid phase. First thing we're going to take advantage of is that fugacity, say for component A, in the liquid phase equals fugacity of component A in the vapor phase. And then I'm going to use notation that's often used, the hat indicating component A in a mixture. And in the vapor phase, at these low pressures, fugacity is really close to the partial pressure. If it's an ideal gas, it is indeed the partial pressure. So the fugacity of A is just the partial pressure of A is 0.2 bar. And of course, that means the fugacity of B in the liquid phase is its partial pressure in the gas phase that's in equilibrium with it, 0.8 bar. And so fugacity of B in the liquid phase is greater than the fugacity of A in the liquid phase, even though the mole fraction or the concentration of B is lower than that of A. So in this problem, we're adding salt to water. We add enough salt to saturate the water, and we continue adding salt, and we have salt sitting on the bottom of the container. And the question is, does salt or water have the higher fugacity? So again, we can look at what's in equilibrium in the vapor phase. So in the vapor phase, the fugacity of water in the liquid phase is going to be approximately the mole fraction of water in the liquid phase times the saturation pressure of water. We don't know. Let's just make estimate because these are order of magnitude. Let's say it was mole fraction is half, probably higher than that. And then the saturation pressure of water at 25 degrees, about 0.03 bar. So we'd say fugacity of water is approximately 0.015 bar. Well, the fugacity of salt then in the liquid phase, right? So this is the liquid phase, would be, again, it's mole fraction times its saturation pressure, mole fraction of salt in the liquid phase times the saturation pressure of salt. Well, let's say this was 0.5. The saturation pressure, we don't know offhand, but our experience would say salt doesn't evaporate in our lifetime. So let's make it 10 to minus 10 bar as a guess. Maybe it's 10 to minus 15 bar. All that matters is that the fugacity of water is much, much greater than the fugacity of salt in the liquid phase. And that's what the question's asking. So in this case, we have pure water at 75 degrees. And we have two concentrations, so they're in different phases. And the question is, which one of these has the higher fugacity? Well, we need more information. We can't tell from concentrations which has a higher fugacity. And so if we go to steam tables and look up usually what's listed as specific volume, if we take that inverse, and again, steam tables are usually in grams or kilograms, and we convert it to moles, we find out that this happens to be the density of the vapor at 75 degrees, saturated vapor, and this happens to be the density of saturated liquid at 75 degrees C. So we can say the fugacity of the liquid is equal to the fugacity of the vapor in equilibrium. And so these two concentrations actually have the same fugacity because they're in equilibrium.